Welcome to another edition of the Secret Diary of an Entrepreneur. The weather in the UK has been pouring with rain. And you know when you just get that kind of feeling, you want to just get cozy up, you want to just get in bed, you want to stay in bed, don't even want to get out of bed today, I was struggling to get out. And you just want to just sit in front of a nice film to watch with a nice hot cup of chocolate, and that will be my day the whole day. It's kind of like rainy slash slush puppy kind of weather. The weather hasn't decided if it's going to rain or wants to snow. So because the day is a bit cold, as you can see I've got my jacket on, I wanted to do something a bit more relaxed, something in my front room. This is my front room here. My video today is 7 books you need to read before you turn 40. I was going to do 30, but as I've passed 30, I've given people a chance to read the book, so obviously I'm entitling it, you know, 7 books you should read before you turn 40. Okay, I've read all these books, as you can see when I showed you my wooden bookshelf. My first one is The Science of Getting Rich. Now, I know this is quite a popular book for a lot of people. If you haven't heard of The Science of Getting Rich, it's quite a well-known book and a lot of people read the book. I've known about the book for probably about 6 years now, and that was my first time I read the book when I went on my journey of personal development, when you know a few things had happened in my life, and you know I started deciding I wanted to improve myself. You know, when you leave school, hence being a teacher, you know, I've always done education, always studied, always marking people's work, so I was used to kind of education, but you know, kind of superficial education, never really looking deep within and kind of discovering, you know, why I do what I do, why I want the things that I want, and kind of like where I'm going in the future, my visions, my whys, my likes, my dislikes, all that kind of thing. I decided on a personal journey development. Both my husband and I decided on a personal development journey, and we've just read books upon books upon books, listened to audio, watched things online, on YouTube, and just kind of filled our mind with positive thinking and things that's going to aid us and take us to the next destination of our lives. And I can truly say reading books is one key way for you to kind of like develop yourself in a short space of time and cost effectively as well, you know. So reading books is one of those, but reading books, it's such a good way for you to just constantly just be checking on yourself really, and kind of like knowing where you are. It's kind of giving you points and landmarks, you know, giving you signposts in your life. You know, sometimes for me, what happens with me and my husband as well is like, you know, when we need the next top up in our life, we always tend to bump into that book. We always travel to lots of old bookstores and try and rummage in there and see any gems that we can find. And we found some great gems traveling all around the country and going to old bookshops. And you know, if you are not an avid reader, I would advise you that you would start this year to read, even if it's one book. Let me talk about my first book, The Science of Getting Rich. I love this book. What motivated me to read the book really was obviously when I started my personal development journey 8 years ago, it came up a lot on a lot of the people that were talking about, like Bob Proctor, Jim Rohn, you know, a lot of the people that motivational speakers were talking a lot about this book. And so obviously, you know, we were starting that journey, I picked up the book and I read it, and what a great book it was. It was quite difficult for me to read at the beginning because it had quite old English. At least the copy I had was old English. I've got a more modern one now, but when I first read it, it was quite an old version of it. There's lots and lots of versions of it that you can get on Amazon and other bookstores online. You know, you can even probably get a digital copy of it as well. Now, this book is really good because it focuses on your mind. It focuses on kind of your subconscious mind, why people are not successful in the sense of they're not making money, or why people making money, losing money, all that kind of thing. it doesn't just always focus about money, but it's kind of more on your desire and your wants, because we don't really associate your desires and your wants. Well, I didn't associate my desires and my wants with the reason why I wasn't making money or why I wanted to acquire money. So the science of getting rich is focuses on your subconscious mind, talks about your desires and your whys, you want to be successful, why you want to create wealth and all that kind of great stuff. So with all the books I'm going to be doing reviews today, I'm going to put a link below the video so you can have a look at them, you can read reviews, there's a lot of reviews online, and you can go and purchase it yourself. I'm not making any money from any of the books that I'm sharing with you today. It's just the books that are on my bookshelf, and like I said, it's a rainy day outside, so I was going to sit and do this video just to tell you the books that I'm reading or I have read. So that's a great one. The next one is Success Intelligence by Robert Holden. This is a really, really good book. Now, again, like I said to you, it's good for you to read books out of your comfort zone. I don't know about you, but for me, normally when I read a book, well, when I started reading a book, I normally kind of get a book and choose someone that looks kind of trendy. If it's someone like past a certain age bracket, I tend to kind of like not get the book. That's what I used to be like before, but not now, because when I read this book, I mean, Robert Holden's not that old, you know, but he's much older than me. It's such a great book. This one, Success Intelligence, talks about, I mean, the subtitles, Essential Lessons and Practices from the World's Leading Coaching Program on Authentic Success. You know, this book again was great because it talks a lot of people want to be successful. You know, we use that term success all the time, and to be honest with you, I use that word a lot as well. But you know, what does success really mean? There's a great chapter in this book where he talks about that you have to define what kind of success that you are looking to achieve, because if you don't define it, if you don't write it down, if you don't kind of know what that success looks like, if it's going to be you want a new house, you want to be driving a new car, you want to be successful in your business, you want to help 10,000 people be successful as well, you know, you have to kind of define what your success is, you know. And that's the thing with success, it's so different for every individual person. Just like a fingerprint, we all have different fingerprints, we all have different tastes and dislikes and things like that, and success is a bit like that. But sometimes we can get caught up and we think success has to look a particular way, or it has to look and dress in a particular way, and it's very important that you define success. And that's what Robert Holden talks about in his book. So he mentions in one of the chapters that if you can define what success looks like for you, then when you arrive at success, then you know that you are successful. And that was just that small little gem was really profound for me. So I kind of defined what success looked like for me and what I saw success was like in my life. And then when I kind of had a picture of it, and then when I worked towards it, then I know that I've arrived at success. Because if you continue to just busy just doing things and not checking, you will never know that you've arrived at the place that you wanted to arrive at. You've arrived at your destination. You could just be beating yourself up and just continue to do work overload, and you probably have arrived at success already. So he teaches a lot of that, and he talks about authentic living, you know, making sure it's not all about money, making sure that you're living kind of true to yourself, kind of listening to your feelings, listening to your gut and emotion. Again, it's all about your subconscious, but also gives you practical things that you can do, because he does a lot of coaching with like top athletes, top BBC presenters, you know, doctors. He works with a lot of people, so he kind of opens his world of coaching in this book, so you kind of have a background view and kind of look into what he does as well. So this is a great book, Success Intelligence. He's got some other great books out there as well. Robert Holden is the one for you to watch out for. So if you can find any of his other books on Amazon online, I would suggest for you to get them. He is a great author, a great writer. The next one is The Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle. Now, I don't know if you heard about Eckhart Tolle. The first time I found out or was introduced to Eckhart Tolle was on Oprah. on the own show, and it was on Oprah Winfrey show. She invited him to come around. He's kind of like a, I won't call him a personal development person, he's more like a guru, like a self-help guru. He teaches a lot of great things, and I love the power of now. Again, I heard about the power of now from Oprah interviewing him on her radio show, and he was talking about the book, and it sounded so good because he talks about, you know, that again, you got to live in the moment, you got to live in the now. Sometimes we can get caught up in pursuing the future, or we can get caught up in living in the past. And he talks about being present in the now and living now, living life now. And it's such a profound book. Again, I read a lot of books that kind of like help me grow in my personal life and also help me grow in my business life. The books that I'm sharing with you today are mainly on my personal journey and, you know, things that can help you grow in your mind. But if, again, like I've said in all my other videos, you know, if you're investing in your business, if you are in a business startup, the main engine and the main thing that runs that business to be successful or failure is you. So investment in your personal development is such a great thing to do. So The Power of Now is a good book for you to get. Love that book. Now I'm going to do a shameless plug-in for my book, which I just released and launched on Amazon and all other bookstores just about a week ago. In fact, you've got another book that's coming out in a week, but I'll tell you that in another video. And this one's called Affiliate Marketing for Women. Now, what motivated me to write Affiliate Marketing for Women was I do a lot of coaching. I help a lot of small to medium businesses, a lot of women. And so when I sat down and I talked a lot with the women, a lot of them had such a desire, passion to want to bring, you know, extra income into their home. They had a desire to build something because, you know, a lot of them had that motivation for their family. It was their children that was kind of stirring them on to do something really big. You know how a woman is, you know, they'll fight and die for their children. I know I will fight and die for my children. So that kind of really motivated me to kind of write something that could give them step-by-step guide on how to do something that could bring that extra income home. They wouldn't have to leave their 9-to-5 job. They could do it while they were working as well. Because, you know, when I started out in business, I did not leave my full-time job. I couldn't afford to leave my full-time job. So I gradually reduced my hours at work, working as a business studies teacher, and spent a lot of my time late nights up to 3 o'clock a.m. in the morning, come home from work, feed the kids, do the housework, and then get to work around about 8:30 p.m. at night, right to 3 a.m., 4 o'clock in the morning, and then get them dressed and out of the house by 7:30. So I did that for probably about 2 years. And what I found when I started out my journey was affiliate marketing was a great way for me to bring in extra income into my home, as well as not having to leave my 9-to-5 job. Because I didn't have a product, I didn't know what I wanted to do, I didn't know how to even find a product. So I had a lot of holes and gaps in my understanding of business. And I came about affiliate marketing when I was doing my research online, when I invested in some products and some training programs on generating income, and a lot of them talked about affiliate marketing. So I did a lot of affiliate marketing. The first thing I actually did was, because I didn't have the spare funds to actually pay for a lot of the programs, was I one of the first programs I came across was one about eBay's, being an eBay seller. And so I realized I could do that because I had a lot of stuff in my house, good quality stuff that I could sell. I had a lot of DVDs because I had a lot of young children at that time, so I used to just plug the DVD on while I did the housework or while I got on with my businesses. So I must have accumulated, and no lie, round about 600 to 800 DVDs. Sounds really bad, but I actually accumulate them. I used to get them for a really good price. So that was one of the things that most, you know, you get like a deal, buy 5 for the price of 2 or something like that. So I was constantly buying DVDs. And it was over a period of 5 years that I built up that amount of DVDs. children's DVDs. My husband and I love watching kung fu movies, so we've kind of like invested into that. And I think as well, because we're going on our journey of development, it was kind of good because we used to work hard, and then we used to play even harder. So our play time, our relaxed time, was sitting in front of the movie TV and just watching a lot of DVDs. So I had quite a lot of DVDs that I wanted to get rid of. It was kind of like detoxing, because I was starting to get to the place where I just didn't have enough time to watch the DVDs, and my children weren't interested anymore. They were growing older, hanging around with friends and stuff like that. So I got into affiliate marketing, which was I went into eBay, got my DVDs and started selling them on eBay. I mean, actually eBay and Amazon. I didn't get a lot of money for it, but it was just so exciting when someone would order it. Mainly was on Amazon when people were ordering, and I put in the package, I'll close the envelope up and put the address, get the receipt, because Amazon will give you like a printed, a ready print receipt. I felt like I was really in business and I really enjoyed it. So I did a lot of other things as well. I did a lot of online marketing, affiliates where you can get banners and you can put it on your website. I created a blog. I've got banners from different well-known companies like Tesco's, like Asda, like review blogs, like fashion blogs, all that kind of thing. But that's what I kind of share with you in affiliate marketing for women. I give you step-by-step guides on how you can start affiliate business and start generating income into your home. It's also got a bonus chapter at the back of the book, which is entitled, flick through it here, Rising to the Super Affiliate Level. So that was a great bonus one. It gives you literally step-by-step things that you can do on day one, day two, day three. So affiliate marketing for women, you can get that on Amazon. I'll leave a link below. My next book is by Fiona Arnold, and it's Reinvent Yourself, 7 Steps to a Fresh You. It's a small book, but I absolutely love this book because Reinvent Yourself, it gives you such great tips about branding, but from a different perspective. She was a bum. She was actually homeless. She came from a quite well-off background, but you know, those hippie days where you go and you just smoke spliff and you just chill out, dude, and all that kind of thing. So she went on that journey and she got into the wrong crowd of people. They used to squat in the house, and she was getting bigger and heavier, and she was getting more depressed and depressed. And then one day she just decided that she didn't want to live this life anymore, that she wanted to get off the streets and she wanted to clean herself up. And she literally went from having nothing to building a consultancy business where she helped to motivate people to reinvent themselves. It was a really, really good book, some great pointers in there where she talks about a lot of stars that you wouldn't know had different names. That Elton John had a really, like, just a basic, unusual name before he became Elton John. And when I read his name, I wouldn't even believe it, just didn't suit him. His actual real name that he was born with didn't actually suit him. Elton John suited him much better. So she talks about things like maybe even moving your location, maybe even changing your name. You know, if you want to build a brand, if you want to reinvent yourself, you've got some things in your life and you know you just want to start a whole new life, you want to refresh yourself, you want to just take yourself to a next stage in your life, Reinvent Yourself by Fiona Arnold is such a great book. So again, all the books and the reviews that I'm doing today, I'm going to leave a link below where you can get them. Another book by Fiona Arnold, I just love this one, The 10 Minute Life Coach. This is a great book, The 10 Minute Life Coach, where she talks about life coaching yourself. Now, I'm not advocating that you should invest in a life coach. I do believe in a life coach. I do believe in investing outside yourself, time, money, and in people to invest in you. Because sometimes when you step out from your comfort zone and you kind of take a step back from your life, and you allow someone else to come into your life, they will see things that you wouldn't see. It can be scary to invite a coach into your life. I've had a coach, we've had a marriage coach come into our home for a period of a year, and we worked on our marriage. This was about, yes, it was about 9 years ago. We were going through some rocky things, and we invited someone in, and they gave us some pointers that we weren't happy about, some things that we were happy about, and things we needed to work on. So I would suggest, and I would advise, that you should think about getting a coach into your life. But she talked about in the 10 minute life coach about how you can constantly follow techniques where you can, the coaches use, so you can coach yourself. I mean, it's like we all have to get up in the morning, brush our teeth, have a wash, dream ourselves, you know, it's constant, constant, constant. You know, I heard someone said that, you know what, motivation's not really good. You know, if motivation was really good, we wouldn't really need it. Just like brushing your teeth, having a wash, we need to do it every day. And that's the same thing with motivation, you need to do it every day. You always need to be topping yourself up with motivational videos, motivational books, things that are just going to pump your mind and pump your belief that you can achieve and be whatever you like to be in life. And so the 10-minute life coach is one of those things that will help you just get pumped up for your life. And the reason why I did this last book, I love this book. I mean, look how old it is. It's literally falling to pieces. It's got stains on it and everything. The Master System by Charles Hanel. You cannot get this book off me. I mean, me and you will be fighting. I mean, girlfriend, we will have a fight if you wanted to get this one. The Master Key System. Brilliant book. If you haven't heard of it, you need to get this book. I've had this book for, gosh, 11 years, as you can tell. And what we do, how I read this book is my husband and I will, after we've had a long day, we'll get ourselves changed, put the kids into bed, and we'll get into bed and we'll read this book. It advises you to read this book like read a chapter a week. So one chapter a week. The reason why he advises you to read it like this is because, you know, when you're doing a lot of things and you read a lot of books or you study I think mainly when you're studying and reading books, you take something in but it doesn't really go in. And you like go back and you look at that and it's like, did I read that? Did I see that? You know, it's like your brain needs to take a while. You need to have a while before you kind of like get the gist and kind of digest what was just written down or what was just said. And that's why he advised you to read one chapter a week. It was quite a struggle. I wanted to come, it's quite a thin book, so I wanted just to like proofread it and just read it really quick. But it was kind of like detox myself to slow down and do exactly as he has said. And I've been reading this book every night, even if my husband and I have a fight and we ain't talking and we had a little tiffle, we will make sure by the end of the day that we are give ourselves kisses, because we know we have to read this book. This book has radically, I've seen it change my husband's life. His life has just gone to the next level. I mean, and I know he won't mind me telling you, I come from a home where there was a lot of motivation. You know, my mum was always encouraging. She was a single mum, but she was one of those people that she would just encourage you, tell you that you could be anything, do anything, have anything that you wanted. You know, I grew up in a home, never knew that such anything like failure or you couldn't succeed. You know, it's only when I grew into my teens and got into the wrong crowd of people, they just kind of dragged me down. So it's very important, the crowd of people that you hang about with as well. But she was a very, very, very motivating person. I love her to bits. You know, I'm so glad I grew up in that home. I wouldn't be who I am today without, if it wasn't for my mum and just the way she was. But when I got into a relationship with my husband, he was the total extreme, the opposite. There was no motivation in his home. His parents didn't encourage him. If he wanted to do something, they would say, no, you can't do it. You know, money doesn't grow on trees. You know, he used to tell me the stories that they used to buy like a bar of Snickers bar and kind of split it into four. Not because they didn't have the money. It was just had this kind of like stingy mentality that there was not enough to go around. He came from a home where they had the money to be able to live the lifestyle that I had. I came from a home where I didn't have the money, but I had the belief, we had a belief that we could have and be. And when you have that belief, even if you don't have enough to go around, it seems to stretch. By some kind of miracle, it seems to stretch. I read another great book about, they were talking about, I can't remember the name of the book, about currency, that money really isn't a piece of paper, isn't a coin that you hold in your hand. Money is currency, and currency literally doesn't have a body. You know, it doesn't have a physical appearance. It's kind of like wind. And when you understand that currency is not actually something that you can tangibly touch, then you will see that you can create currency, you can create money, and you can create the wealth that you want just by your thoughts and your belief. And I saw that in my life, my upbringing, that, you know, my mum wasn't, you know, wealthy, but she just had a belief that she could be and do, and she started cleaning and working old people's home, and gradually sort of got bigger and bigger and bigger until she became a director of an old people's home, running, you know, 5 to 6 old people's homes. So I saw that play out in my life, that when you believe that you can have and achieve and want anything you want, you can have it. Not saying that you don't have times when you have to stop, take a gap, rest, you know, we're going to have failures, we're going to have things that don't work out for us. But if we just have that belief, that if we just continue to go that direction and believe that things will change, that tomorrow will be another day, things will work out for us. So The Master Key System by Charles Hanel, such a great book to have in your bookshelf. Now that's my 7 books that you should read before you turn 40. Guys, I'd like to thank you so much for watching my videos. Also like to give you a big kiss to all those new subscribers that subscribe to my YouTube channel. I would love for you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I've had it for just over a year, but I've just avidly started posting some YouTube videos to it, and really because I just love doing it. We've got 21 subscribers and I'm just so happy doing videos. Even if it's just me, myself, and I doing the video and no one watching, I'll still be doing my videos, because it's just a way where I can express myself in another way. But I would love for you to subscribe, because if you subscribe to my channel, you will get notified by YouTube when any other new videos I post onto my YouTube channel. So thanks guys for watching, and have yourself a great weekend and a great week, a great day wherever you are in the world. Take care guys, bye.